As a potter, I've been making mugs for decades. I've made thousands and thousands of mugs. And after making about 10,000 mugs, I've learned to understand the form. I've also learned that mugs are one of the best-selling pots you'll make. You will sell more mugs than any other pot you make. And so if you're going to be a potter, you have to learn how to make mugs very quickly and very well, I guess is a better word. And so here I'm at the point where the question is, a lot of people ask, is a mug an art form, or are mugs just a skill or a craft? My answer to that question is, well, yes. There's a lot of people like myself who make a lot of mugs. My mugs are very well formed, they're balanced, they're very well crafted, and they are a skill and a technique. There are other people. I have a friend I've known for years in Dawson Creek, BC. Her name's Dory, and she makes beautiful mugs. Each mug is a little canvas for her art. And so for me, mugs are a craft, and for her, mugs are an art form. Your mugs are yours. They can be whatever you like. Anyway, before we start making our mugs, we have to make sure we get started. Now, when I sit down to make mugs, I'll make about 24 mugs, and then I'm mugged. I don't want to make more than that today because I really don't like making mugs. It's a job that you have to do. So before we get started, I like to pug or wedge up or get your clay ready for your throwing. And like I said, 24, and that's enough for a day. But before you sit down, I like to make sure I've got my water. I've got my board. I'm gonna put the mugs on. I like to work on a paper on top of the board because quite often your mugs can stick to the wood, but if they stick to the paper, they'll peel right off when the leather hard. So I've got my board is ready to hold the mugs. I've got my needle. I like to use a heavier needle during throwing and a smaller one. I have my little sponge on a stick to clean it out. I have my sponge for throwing. This stick we'll talk about later. And every mug of mine is 5.5 inches tall when it's thrown. And here's my caliper. Now these are really cool tools, and we'll be talking more about these tools and my fancy stick in our new series called Three Handmade Tools. And you know how fun it is to say three handmade tools. Anyway, check out Three Handmade Tools, and I'll talk about the tools I've been making over the years. As I mentioned, decades of doing this stuff. Anyway, I'm gonna get started making some mugs. I've got all my supplies are ready to go. I have my clay wedged. I'm gonna grab a mug pug. Now these mug pugs are about 500 grams. I make it a little bit bigger than I want it to be because I'm gonna make my mug bigger than I want it to be and cut it down to the size of my caliper. I'm gonna put it on the middle of the wheel, yeah, with a little bit of attitude, and I'm gonna turn my wheel on and it'll go faster. And I'm going to center this quickly. Centering, I'm right-handed, so my left hand's going to just push up with the heel of my palm, and my right hand is going to push down there. And it's just that up and down motion that puts it on to center. Now, after you push up in the middle and down in the middle, your clay has nowhere else to go but the middle. So it's centered, can open it up. My left hand stays just where it is. My right hand just going to slide down in there, and my middle finger is going to go down, but be very careful not to go right to the bottom because we are making mugs and not little planters. I'm down where I want to be. I'm going to pull my right hand to the palm of my left. If you're not sure how thick that is, you can with your needle go down there and measure. You want about that much on the bottom, and after a while it'll just happen. So I'm going to pull that toward the palm of my hand. And then both hands, left and right, are going to go up. You see, in that one pull, you get a lot of height. Going to switch. Left hand goes on the inside, right hand goes on the out. And I'm just going to pull up. And that's it. And it starts to flare at the top. You might find you wanted to stop there and cut it in. I'm just about to height. I think we'll give it one more pull just to straighten it out a bit. This is it, then you can just go pull it up. Now I mentioned I start off with a thicker needle and a thinner needle. I'm going to use a thicker needle, and I'm going to trim this. This pot, when it comes off the wheel, will be ready for a handle. I don't trim or do anything else to a mug after I'm done, but sponge it a bit and put a handle on it. And so now I've got that excess off of there. Put my hand in and give it some shape. And I picked up that weight. Now at this point, before my mug goes in too much, I'm gonna take my sponge, I'm gonna go right down on the inside. My middle finger's longer, and I'm gonna work the bottom with that. It'll absorb the water, and I'll make the bottom tidy. If someone is drinking coffee from their mug and they have cream and sugar in it, and they stir, they don't want a bunch of bumps for your spoon to go dancing over. So I'm just gonna put that in there. And now I have a tidy bottom. And I'm gonna bring it up, straighten it out a little bit. And measure 5.5 inches. You always measure 5.5 inches after you cut, because this is under the curve, if that makes any sense. And if it's under the curve, the same amount is going to be the same height. And if it's out there, it's going to change the height. This is going to make it a little bit taller. And cut it down to 5.5. Use the thinner needle. And I'm just going to cut that off on that mark. I like to keep my excess clay there. It gives me somewhere to keep my needles. Now I'm going to tidy that out. Tidy that out? How about tidy that up? I'm going to give it a bit more tummy on the bottom, give a bit more belly, a bit more shape. And now I have my sponge on a stick. Again, check out Pottery Handmade Tools, and I'll talk about making your own sponges on a stick. As you see, without instruction, they're very complex. Perhaps not. Give it a little bit of shape. Now, this is almost ready for taking off, but I want to be able to bring this up to my mouth and have the brim of the cup very smooth. Now, this is just a piece of plastic, and I just got a little bit wet, and I am just going to bend that over. Some people like to use a chamois. I prefer plastic. One's chamois takes on the clay color, and I always lose it in the recycle. And the piece of plastic is cheaper than leather chamois. This little stick is this little sculpting stick. It's lost its point because I'm going to run it around the bottom and give it some shape there. Now this mug, when it comes off, except for a bit of stamping and sponging, is ready for a handle. Now this wire, this is a neat kind of trick. The wires, again, we'll talk about in our 3 handmade tools. It goes with the sticks to the end of my little fingers. My index finger and my pointer finger stick out, and I can wrap around. Now I have control over this wire, and I can, when I put my thumbs down, have it just the size of the base of your mug. I'm going to pull it tight and pull it toward me, pulling a layer of water under there. And it comes right off. If it doesn't come off with the slightest little pull, cut it again. But you want to make sure it's tight, because if it curls up like that, you're going to cut the bottom of your mug off. Now I'm just going to put it over there with the rest of its family in it. You notice they're all different sort of shapes, but they're all kind of the same. When you all get handles on them, they'll all look the same. So we're going to do that again. Before we're going to do it again, we have to make sure your wheel head is clean. Take all that last mug off of there. It doesn't have to be completely dry. You just can't have the last mug on there for this mug. This mug is going to go on again in the middle, kind of middle, with a bit of attitude. I'm just going to push it up and push it down and push it up and push it down. It's going to go on center. And after it's centered, I'm going to open it. My little finger is going to go down to the palm of my hand and up. Then we're going to move to the inside, and we're going to pull up. I'm pulling up at this part. My inside hand is quite a bit lower than my outside hand, and as it pulls up, they come together. You can see I'm getting quite a bit of height on that. One more time. Go down and get that clay. That's near the top. We're going to bring it in this way. Every time you pull in, you have to, every time you push in, you have to pull up. It has to go somewhere. Gonna go down, move that open, get rid of that excess with the heavy needle. Join it down, pull it up, and gonna go down and pick up that clay, make the bottom round, and then pull up. Then before I close it up too much, I'm gonna go down with my sponge and my fingers, gonna make the bottom tidy. Always has to be tidy. Then it's a little bit thick, so I'm just gonna shape it a bit. And cut that off. With the thin one. My stick, I'm gonna go clean it up. It's too tall now. As it gets thinner, it gets taller. Okay, now it's done. I'm just gonna tidy up this edge. Give it a bit of shape. Make it smooth. Now at this point, if you like, you could get a second caliper and you could measure the top and make sure every one of the tops are the same size. But you'll find after you start working that they all come out kind of the same size. And again, it's a mug. So I'm gonna undercut it. That's basically mugs. When I throw a mug, it's not absolutely perfect. Very few of us are absolutely perfect. It is a mug. It's not mathematically round, but I don't really care. They're a nice mug. They're well balanced when they come out of the kiln, so they function well as a mug. But when you're throwing mugs, find a shape that works for you. I've been making this shape for years. My hands can make them fairly easily. So once you've got your mug pugs and you're ready to go, turn your music up and see if you can find that little mug zen place in your mind and go there and make as many mugs as you can, because that zen place isn't going to last long. Anyway, that's mug. Make as many as you can. Have fun with making your mugs. I'll come back in a day or two, and these are leather hard, and we'll put some handles on them.